What's up guys, my name is Matt Zeffi. Today I wanted to do a tutorial on what I think is one of the most important aspects about video editing, and that is staying organized. I'm not even exaggerating when I say this has been one of the most helpful softwares that I've ever used. I was personally introduced to this software back in 2015 and I've been using it ever since on every single project that I've done, especially large projects when it's even more important to stay organized. I find that when you're dealing with long projects and even when you're working with other editors, forget about it, it's another story. I've received hard drives from people from other editors and it's just crazy to look at, really hard and annoying to understand. So I'm telling you, if you can follow these tips, you're gonna help other people out and you're gonna help yourself out. Another thing that's really fantastic about this is that it's not just limited to video editors. You could do this if you're doing any kind of motion graphics, if you're doing things in Photoshop. And it comes with these pre-made templates inside it. But one of the greatest parts there is that you could actually edit these templates, make duplicates of these templates and edit those. You could share them with friends. You could do all sorts of things with these templates. And it's gonna help you stay consistent, which is extremely important when you're editing. And I haven't encountered any softwares that are even similar to this, but the fact that this one's free and it's so useful is pretty amazing. I'm gonna leave a link to it down below in the description if you wanna go ahead and download that now so that you're able to follow me in this video, or you can give it a download later on afterwards. Whatever works for you. I'm gonna jump right in. Let's get started. All right guys, so this is basically what you should be looking at when you first download Post Haste. It's a fairly simple software. They don't update it very often, which is kind of nice because everything seems to work perfectly and there's no need to update what's not broken. I'm going to start off by showing you what a new project is for. Basically, this tab is for whenever you start a new project. So you're going to come into here and this first value should be 1 if this is the first time that you're using the software. And every time you start a new project, it will go up in value. Kind of just an easier way to keep track of the number of projects you're doing. And you can see all the projects that you've done in numerical order. So this client part, there's actually a drop-down menu. I'm not gonna show you the clients here. I just put my own name for now. Basically, you're gonna fill that in with whatever client you are working for that. Project name, self-explanatory. Date, it's gonna do automatically. And editor, you are gonna wanna set yourself if you're editing it, or maybe someone else is using your computer. This could be helpful to have a drop-down menu with other names in it. For me, it's just me using this computer, so it's only me as the editor. Up here, you will see project template, and you could actually drop this down and look at all the templates that you have. This is great because not every project is the same. Some are visual effects heavy, some are more just simple editing heavy, and you only need certain things in your project bins for that. For instance, I have this trimmed down basic template, and that's basically only the essentials that I need to get going. And it's the project bins that I always use, and it's more for simpler projects, and extended basic is a little bit more than that. So I think just 3 of these, extended basic, post-haste tutorial, which I just created, and the trim down basic are the only ones that I created myself. The rest usually come with Digital Rebellion. To create your own templates, you're gonna want to move into where the fun happens in the templates page. So this is the template that I just compiled. It's very similar to the other templates that I actually use in real life. Basically, you have your Adobe After Effects folder. This is if you're doing anything with Adobe After Effects involving Premiere or just Adobe After Effects separately. And you could save your renders into this folder. And I also have a Adobe Premiere Pro, which is what I use. So the whole purpose of naming these things templates, or what they actually function as, is these things are actually going to be titled whatever you input it into these blank spaces on this new project page. So your folder that Post-Haste is going to create is going to be called this, as well as the projects for Adobe After Effects and Adobe Premiere and some other projects that you could do as well. And that's why they're named template. So moving on, I also have a folder for approvals. That's when I'm sending it to a client, and those are kind of just like drafts.
audio, which can you can really elaborate here. You could have scores, voiceovers, sound effects, production sound, anything like that that can go into your audio folder. Delivery is where I usually put my final export and just makes it easier to find that export if I need to revert to it in the future. So editing notes is something that I recently implemented into this workflow, and it's because I found that it would help future editors if they were to look at a hard drive that I'm working on or project that I'm in. And I usually just kind of detail everything and where everything is in these folders to help them, although I think it's pretty self-explanatory, but it just helps even further, and I wish that an editor left me with that. But beyond just an editor, if a client were to look at the hard drive and look inside the hard drive, if it were a scenario where the client has the hard drive, then it's going to help them as well, especially. So this is definitely something that will be useful to other editors as well as yourself, because if you know you're going to be looking at this project long time down the line, and you want to know where everything is and what everything functions as, and this text document, which will be in every project folder, will really help you out. And then media is where I put all my footage, original camera, and when I create the proxies, I put it in the proxy folder. So that's about it for this template. And like I said, these are really customizable. All you have to do is come down here and just select what you want to add, new folder or particular projects. But it does go beyond this. Like I said, you can customize bins within these projects so that every time you open this project, when you create the folder, then it will actually load your customary bins in there, which is pretty nice. So to set that up, you would just double click this template. You can also do this with other Adobe programs as well, but basically you just want to double click this template. If this particular project, Adobe project, is an outdated version of Adobe, you will have to save that again and just replace this template project. Make sure it's the same exact name, template. So you're going to want to rename it to template without the underscore one, and then you'll be good to go. So you're just going to open this and then just set up your Adobe Premiere Pro bins as you normally would, and then make sure you save it at the end, close. And then when you go to create your project later, so I create my project, I'm actually going to save it to my desktop for now. So here's my project. As you can see, it's titled what we had filled into those spaces. So if I open it up, I get those bins we just named. And as you can see, the projects are named exactly as the folder was named, which we specified beforehand in post-haste. And if I open this up, it will open up all of the bins that I normally use in Premiere Pro. This includes sequences. I like to use adjustment layers pretty much right off the bat, so I actually have an adjustment layer created. You can have your assets already in there if you have specific assets that you know you're going to be using for a specific client numerous times. You could already have those loaded in there into Premiere. And an example of what bins you might want to create could be a sequences bin, an audio bin, maybe a titles bin, although this was more useful with the legacy titles in Premiere. Additional ones could be obviously your typical media bin. And then other than that, it's pretty much up to you, but there's really so much you could do with this software. It's pretty incredible. And what's really great about this is that it keeps you consistent, and you know your folder structure is going to be exactly the same on every project. And if you're dealing with the same client, that's pretty great to have. So I highly recommend this software. It's a great thing to have in your arsenal, and that's about it for this.
So that's about it, guys. A short and sweet tutorial, but it's extremely useful if you apply this to your workflow. If you got anything out of this video, make sure to like and subscribe. And if you have any questions or even suggestions, please leave a comment down below, and I will be getting back to you guys with a ton more videos in the near future. So thanks so much for watching, and take care. I would like you better.